years, but I had myself a major league fastball. Got a call from the minor leagues in Wichita, and I blew out my arm for the very first year. Took a good look at my life, decided I'd make a change. Took me a flight on an airplane. I was third world peace going round.
Let me hear you, Detroit.
But I met me a stewardess waiting right there in the airport bar. Before I knew it, I was in her car and never turned around. On the coast at a club called the High Spot. We took our breaks on the pool night, and we all got fired for smoking a whole lot of pot. Yeah. Woo. Deep right there, I guess surfing was the life of the best. But I got mounted with the wrong dude. If you ain't had enough to drink yet, you can just kind of shake your ass in your seat a little bit if you need to. Here's what we gonna do. About 10 years ago, I moved to Nashville, Tennessee, pursuing this thing. And about 10 months into it, I met with this big-time producer that had produced all these big acts. And he had me play a few songs. He said, "Where you from?" I said, "I'm from South Georgia." So he said, "Well, Kip, this town is tough, and I'd advise you just to pack on up and head on back to South Georgia." So I was polite. I stood up. I shook his hand. I said, "The hell with that, buddy. I ain't going nowhere," and I walked out. An old guitar, cast from a good hand blackjack. Learned a few chords from a fat back, hairy man named Pete. Got a local gig on the weekend, some old honky tonk. Singing 2 hours of nothing but cash song. I could always drink for free. Some supply big wig could do some man stuff, spin around. He told me he liked my sound, but there was something holding me back.